May you be seated. Shout hallelujah. Church, are you really, really blessed about the teachings? Are you sure? Shout hallelujah. Accepting Christ is a covenant. Accepting what? Christ as your Lord and your personal Savior is a what? It's a covenant. And we call it salvation covenant. Salvation what? Covenant. It means that you and I believe 100% that we are saved. Am I right? It means that we have a covenant with our God. Shout amen. I want to take you into deeper tonight and for you to understand this. Exodus chapter 20. Exodus chapter what? Chapter 20. We will pray tonight a lot. And we will declare some things a lot. Look at somebody, ask somebody sitting by you and say, are you really saved? Do you have a relationship with God? Shout hallelujah. Shout amen. Do I have somebody in this room who at times could knife himself or herself small to consult a famine? I'm not doing altar call. If you are like that, change, and change drastically. If not, your God will disgrace you. You cannot serve two masters. If you want to serve demons, serve demons. If you want to serve Christ, serve Christ. When you put one foot in God's house, the right one, you must add left. Do not put right, and left will be in a far house. Those people will never receive miracles. Do you know the reason why? Because when something good occurred in your life, which one are you going to what? Give thanks. Are you going to thank afar, or are you going to thank the Lord? Let me tell you this. Our God is a jealous God. Why God himself said that? Because I am a jealous God. Because Christ Jesus is our husband. Christ is our what? Our husband. Shout amen. And every good husband and a husband who loves his wife will never allow any man to come near what? His wife. Am I right? And so some women or women who love their husband will not allow any woman to what? To come near. Why? Why? Jealousy has to come in. And that one, I call it holy jealousy. We have bad one and holy one. At times, you must use holy jealousy to preserve what God has given unto you. Children are jealous than we adults. If you have a baby, like 2-3 years, whereby he or she knows that, you know, I am alone. When you conceive, they will know that maybe there is baby in your stomach, but let the baby come out. Am I right? As soon as the baby comes out, if you don't take care, that older one can what? Can hurt that small one. Jealousy. Shout amen. Amen. Recently, I think I was lying on the bed or something. Davina went to the mom, I am alone, eh? No baby more anymore. No baby. I am only baby. No more baby. Am I right? Mommy, don't have no more baby. I am the only baby in the house. You see jealousy? And that one is holy jealousy. It's good one. At times you must have that one and to preserve what God has what. Shout amen. That is why the Lord said, I am what? A jealous God. Why? Because marriage is a covenant. Marriage is a what? It's a covenant between man and woman, not woman and woman. That is why in God's own wisdom, the Lord created Adam and what? And Eve. Shout hallelujah. Not Eva and Adam. But the Lord created what? Adam and what? And Eve. Not Peter and John. Shout amen. Amen. Am I speaking to somebody? And the Bible uses marriage as a what? As a covenant between man and a what? And a woman. Shout amen. That is the same thing applies to our salvation. The salvation you and I we have in Christ, it links or it signifies what? Marriage. It means that Christ is your husband. And if Christ sees that there is another man or any different man wants to come in your way, Christ will be what? Will be jealous. Shout hallelujah. But guess what? Because he is a gentle God. Because he is a what? A gentle God. He does not break his covenant. But we men, we what? We break covenant. God is a faithful God. As soon as he makes a covenant with you, there is no way he can break it. That is why our salvation, for you to know Christ, you must rely upon him. Because there is no way he will leave you nor forsake you. In terms of trouble, he will be with you. Shout hallelujah. And listen to me very well. Howard, come. We do respect. Eric, come. Howard, stand here for me. Let's take it. This is, may God forbid, may God be forbid. Let's take it. This is Satan. This is what? Satan. And this is God. This is what? God. Shout amen.
Amen.
Listen to me. Listen to me very well. And let's take it, you are a Christian. And because you are a Christian, your father is who? Which one of them? Which one of them? God Howard. Am I right? Okay. Listen to me. It means that you have a covenant with this God. And the day you will push this God aside, am I right? And worship this, excuse me, may God forbid, this Satan. It means that you want to prove to this man that now you have nothing to do with him. You have another God who is Satan. So now that you have another God, when something happens to you, there is no way this God can come what? In or intervene. Why? Because you've already divorced him. You've already what? Divorced him. There is no way he can come in. That is why it is very dangerous and for somebody to serve other God. Other God in which ways? Those juju people, those afa people, they serve other gods. And you put your God somewhere and serve those gods. Church, it is very dangerous. It is very what? Dangerous. So today, maybe you have no covenant with this God. I beg you in the name of God, after the service, you better run to that your old husband. who is Christ, and renew the covenant you have with what? With him. And divorce this man, because this man has nothing good to give you. He will steal you and kill you and what? And destroy you. But this man can give you everlasting life. Listen to me very well. Do you know the reason why some people pray, God didn't answer them? And we say, oh, God is a merciful God. He hears prayer. Church, it's not any prayer that our God will answer. I am telling you. You cannot divorce him and kick him somewhere. And in terms of trouble, you will say that, Papa God, come and help me. Whereby you are still holding on to that what? That man. You have a covenant with that Satan. And you are crying to this man to come and help you. He will never. Unless you divorce this man and kick this man aside and say that I have no other God. Now, Papa God, may you come and rescue me. That will be the time your God will intervene. But so many people believe that they are fast. They are still holding on to that small idol. And they still want God to do something for them. Don't deceive yourself. Our God is not a magician. He is a principal God. When you have relationship with him, and when you call him in times of difficulties, he will answer you. Amen. The book of Jeremiah 33 verse 3 is not there for anybody. It's there for those who have a covenant with Christ. Do you know the time God can hear somebody's prayer, the one who has a covenant with this man? That will be the time the person will say, the Lord, now I know. May you come and rescue me. I renew the covenant. But you cannot still hold on to what? This man. And still seek for what? Seek for what? Help from this wonderful God. Church, God will never do that, because he is a jealous God. He doesn't want to bring any miracle in your life whereby at the end of the day you will go and give that glory to this one, because he said that I will never share. And because he doesn't want to share his glory with anyone, go and let that your God do it for you. He will not do it, and you will go and give that thanks unto somebody. So if you need a miracle from God, and if you need a touch from God, you better denounce and break that what covenant you have with Satan. That is why I will tell you with that reasonable, witches and wizards, they are wasting their time. Unless they want to give up and divorce that Satan and come to Christ. But if they are still holding on to those spirits and they are still in the house of God doing some things for Christ, moving up in that church, you better change. Because the things that you've been doing and moving up and down and the whole thing, that kind of covenant you have with Satan will not allow you to enter heaven until you divorce that Satan. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm speaking to somebody. When you have a covenant with him, when you cry to him, he will come and rescue you. When you have a covenant with him, in times of trouble, he will never let you down. When you have a covenant with him, he will stand with you. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
How come this great nation, this mighty nation, we have some friends? Am I right? Israel, Japan. Am I right? South Korea, if not Korea, wants to see some anger of this powerful nation, let them try South. You will see what will happen. Why? Because there is a covenant between South and America. There is a covenant between Israel and America. There is a covenant between Great Britain and America. Am I right? There is no covenant between America and North. So if somebody wants to beat North, America will not do anything. That is called a covenant. So when you have a covenant with God, and if somebody wants to come and beat you, your God has to intervene. When you have a covenant with God, and when somebody comes wants to kill you, your God has to come and fight on your behalf. When you have a covenant with God, church, do not joke about covenant. Everybody shout hallelujah. Do not joke about what?
Covenant.
About covenant. It is very powerful and it is very important. I don't know you really understand. Everybody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So tonight, do you want to have a covenant with Satan or do you have a covenant with God? Are you sure?
Yes.
Then listen to me. If you have a covenant with Satan, when you go home today, denounce that Satan. Let me tell you this. When you denounce him, they will come and harass you in your dream. They can even give you warning and say that there is no way you can divorce us. If not, you will go mad. You do. Church, do not be afraid of their stupid things. You just be bold and come to Christ and see what Christ will do to you. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm not speaking to somebody. I'm talking about having a covenant with Satan. Physically, a witch or a wizard. A witch, you know yourself. A wizard, you know yourself. You cannot come to me and say that, Prophet, am I a witch? You yourself, you know. You know yourself more than me. Everybody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And no witch will enter the kingdom of God. And no wizard will enter the kingdom of God. Everybody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm not speaking to somebody. So if you are here and if you have that kind of spirit at the same time, it is difficult for you to let it go. Church, be bold and let it go. Come and seek for deliverance and let it go. And your God will start a new journey with you altogether. No one will hear it. And you will be a new creature. And the Lord will begin to do mighty things in your life. Everybody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
May you clap your hands for Jesus. Everybody shout hallelujah. May you clap your hands for Jesus. Am I speaking to somebody? Am I talking to someone? Look unto your neighbor and say, neighbor, you must break the covenant between you and Satan and come to Christ. Who has a covenant with Christ? Hey, church, let me tell you. If I don't have a covenant with Christ, with all the headaches, all the problems, lies, insult, wahala, this and this, then I will be in trouble. But because I have a covenant with Christ, I know that my reward is great. So, when you have a covenant with God, you can go through so many things, but you have the word called assurance and peace. You will know that one day, your reward and the peace and the assurance we have in Christ keep us moving. It keeps us what? Moving. Do you know that something that can cause somebody to commit suicide? I'm telling you with that reason, but you and I, we've already passed that stage. The thing that caused somebody to commit a suicide, 10 times knock your door. Am I right? But you didn't kill yourself. You are still alive. Do you know the reason why you didn't kill yourself? Because you have hope. You have hope. You have peace. You know that I have a covenant with God. And one day, because I have a covenant with God, my Father shall intervene. Let me tell this. Having a covenant with God will give you peace. That's why the word of the Lord said that righteous as bold as what? It's a lion. When you have covenant with God, you will have peace. Everybody shout amen.
Amen.
Do not let Satan give you any assignment concerning God's people or his church, because your end will be disastrous. And it will be what? It will be bad. And it will be what? It will be rough. Shout amen.
Amen.
Do not. Made a covenant with Christ. Everybody shout hallelujah. Do not let them tell you that you are my mother. Huh? Anytime you are in trouble, call me. I will come and rescue you. Mami Wata doesn't have powers. Our God has power. Shout hallelujah. Shout glory be to God. Shout hallelujah. Our God has what? He has power. May you serve him and see what he will do in your life. And put this thing in your mind. Put this thing in your mind tonight before I read. A witch or a wizard can never kill somebody who had a covenant with God. A witch or a wizard can kill somebody who doesn't have a covenant with God. And that covenant that I'm talking about is protection. We are all God's children. Yes, he shined upon us. He rained upon everything. He lost everybody. But let me tell you this. It's not everybody that have a covenant with God. There are some people that doesn't have protection. But some, they have protection. Do you know the reason why I say that a witch cannot kill a Christian? Let me tell you this. Number one is, if, the word if you will be vigilant. But if you don't become vigilant, something horrible can happen. Vigilant in which ways? You must be wise. If you know that when I go here, this one will bring my death, you don't have to go there. And by you refraining yourself from those places will rather prolong your life. Shout hallelujah. But apart from that, you must be rest assured. Let me tell this. They can fight you. Put it in your mind. Do not say that a Christian, how come they fight me in the hotel? Yes, they will surely gather themselves and come. Not they will not. They will come like a flood. Am I right? But the Spirit of God shall raise up a standard. Whether you like it or not, they will fight you. But they are fighting a losing battle. They are not fighting a winning battle. Shout hallelujah. And listen to me. They know, and they know that you have protection.
Amen.
When you are from God, they know. When you belong to them, they know. When you are weak, they know. When you are bragging, talking, they know. Am I right? What are you talking about? They know. Because every Christian or somebody who had a covenant with God, there is a seal. There is a what? A seal. And that seal is the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
And because of blood of Jesus, that has become a seal, you know, concerning your life as somebody who have Christ, no demon can break that seal and to come and finish you untimely. I am here to declare to you, that will be the first prayer we will pray. Declare to you today, anybody that have been assigned and to terminate you and I, our life untimely, get ready, they will die first.
Amen.
I didn't hear amen.
Yeah.
I said they will die first. Then if not, my God is not a what? God or alive. They must die first. Because the word of the Lord said, touch not my anointed. And do my prophet no harm. You are the anointed one. Shout hallelujah. So anybody that wants to terminate your life untimely, get ready. You will rather go to their funeral. Because the one that is in you is greater. Anybody that have been mentioning your name in Afar House,
that they are doing incantation, juju against your picture, against your name, releasing arrows, releasing bullets. Tonight, by the finger of God, it shall return back to the sender, because you are under the rock, and the rock is higher.
Everybody shout hallelujah. Am I speaking to somebody? Am I prophesying to someone? If you believe that, shout hallelujah. You mark it. You mark it. You mark it. And see what the Lord will do unto your life tonight. Church,
if they don't pack, if they don't what? Pack. Your God will pack them by force.
Shout hallelujah. The book of Exodus chapter what? Chapter 20 and verse number 1 coming. Let me read the word of God. I am the Lord your God. I am the Lord your God. Oh, look at this. Tonight, look at what the Lord is saying. The Lord is saying that, Joe, Monique, I am your Lord, thy what? Your God. Do you have God? Then if we have God, let him speak. I am the Lord, your God, who brought you out of Egypt. Do you know Egypt? Who brought you out of bondage, out of the land of slavery. You shall have no other gods before me. This is the warning. You shall not make for yourself an image in the form of anything in heaven, above all on the earth. Am I right? Beneath or in the waters. Am I right? Below. Ye shall not bow down to them or worship them. For I am your God. I am jealous. I am a jealous God. Common sense is not common. The reason is that, look at this. Howard, you just look at this. I will go to the farm, and I will cut bean. Am I right? A what? A bean. I myself will take a cutlass. Am I right? Go to the forest myself, and I will cut a tree, bean. Which, number one, that tree, who put it there? Okay. And you will go and cut it and design the eyes, design the stomach, everything. And you put it in front of your house or inside your house, and you begin to kill some animal, am I right? And put their blood. And you will bow before that beam that you yourself went to farm. James, does it make sense? You yourself will sit down and take a clay. And take a what? A clay. You will design it. Am I right? And harden it through fire and those things. And you will put it in front of your house. And bow before the same thing that you did it with your hand. Are you not crazy? What is this? And you will bow before that wood. I am going to protect me. Where whereby that thing can tell you that, okay, I hear you. We'll be just looking at you. I will never serve any other God that I know their beginning and I know their roots. The reason why I have to serve God is that He is the Ancient of Days. Who was is and is to come. That nobody doesn't know where He came from. The Everlasting Father. The Working Miracle God. The Amazing God. The one who sits in heaven and earth is His what? Full stool. I will worship that God. The one who caused His servant Jesus to walk on lake. The one who created the heavens and the earth. The giver of life and the taker of life. The preserver of life. The Everlasting Father. Jehovah Yahweh. Jehovah Makadishi. Jehovah Tekenu. Oh! May you be on your feet. May you be on your feet. I can't teach anymore. Shout hallelujah. We will serve that God. Said, if I want to take you, I believe that there is no way we can pray. Because tonight we have to pray a lot. Listen to me. Listen to me. So accepting Christ, number one, is a what? A salvation what? Covenant. And God doesn't want you to break that salvation what? Covenant. That is why He said that we must not serve any other God. And we must not bow before any image. Image. And some family homes back home, they have them. They kill some animals. And guess what? And at times, I don't know, Africa, at times they would, what did they call that one? They will do some mashed type of potato, something, plantain, am I right? And they will add a palm oil and some eggs. Lord, we have brought it, may you eat. And they will put it there. Tomorrow, the next day, they will go. And the food is the same. And they will change it and put another one. And it will be the same. Shout amen. Amen. But we serve a God. We serve a God that we don't have to feed Him. But He has to feed us. He found out that His children, what? Israelites, am I right? Were in great trouble. And the Bible says that He manna for them. And the Hebrew word manna means, what is what? What is this? By the time they realized, bread, mighty things started coming from heaven. They started eating. What is this? Manna, 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 manna. What is this? What is this? What is it? God surprised them. So if I can give food to my God and my God cannot what? Eat it, then I won't serve that God. I won't serve that God. A certain guy that his father, through his behavior and some things, his father became born again. His father was idol worshiper. Brought his God, big one, three, in front of the house. Told the son that I'm going to farm. It looked as if rain will come. So in case when rain starts, you must take them inside. The guy has been telling the father, Daddy, I don't think this one, there is nothing, please. The man will say, shut up. This is our God, the God of our what? Forefathers, ancestors. There is no way you can. So the rain started in the whole thing. The guy didn't take it. The guy entered the rooms, you know, cover himself. So the rain soaked all the clay, gauze, and the whole thing. The man came back in the whole. What? He said, Mama, I didn't. I was far. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. We have to kill this. The ghost of that papa has what? They have already washed away. So the man was moving up and down, told his son, he said, guess what? I think I'm stupid. Because the God that I said, that when rain started, my God couldn't enter the room or couldn't help himself. And the rain has washed them. From today going, he started kicking them. I won't serve this God again. I will serve Jehovah Yahweh. Evil spirits. Do you understand the covenant now? The salvation covenant, do you understand now? And do you understand this, that there is, that you don't have to break the covenant you have with God? And let me tell you this. So it means that when you serve other gods, what happened? Or what will happen? It means that you've what? It means that you've what? You've broken what? The covenant you have with what? So do you want to do that? Do you want to do that? Let me tell you this. So it means that when problems comes, when calamity comes, anything that will occur in your life, you must give thanks to God. Do not allow anything to separate you from your God. Do not allow anything to break the covenant you have with your God. No matter what will happen, you must prove to your God that I am still faithful and I will continue to serve you. We have so many Christians, when something horrible happened to us, we put God aside. Let God trust you. May the Lord, you know, have somewhat mighty faith and trust about you, like Job, and said that there is nothing that can cause Job and to what? And to disown me. There is nothing. You must have that covenant. And that is our power. And that is our strength. I wanted to ask some things and for you to understand that salvation covenant. Let me tell you this. So now, if you and I, we have the salvation covenant, then what do we have to do? Can I have 2 minutes? Take your Bible to the book of Ephesians. And be on your feet. Be on your feet, everybody. With due respect. Be on your feet. Ephesians chapter 2. I don't know if we have 2. But I believe that as a Bible student, you have 2. Am I right? Thank you, Jesus. Everybody shout hallelujah. Look unto your neighbor and say, neighbor, do not joke with these teachings. Church, are you really blessed? Are you really blessed? Let me add something to it. Tomorrow shall be a different thing altogether. And tonight, we have some kind of direction. Ephesians chapter 2, verse what? Verse what? Verse number 12. Everybody shout hallelujah. Do you have 12? Let me read verse 11. Please, I'm doing it fast with 2 minutes, please. Therefore, am I reading from the right place? From the NIV. Therefore, remember that formerly you who are Gentiles, am I right? By birth. Can you read? Can you see it? Look at this. Therefore, remember that formerly you who are what? Gentiles. By and called what? Uncircumcised. Am I right? But those who called themselves the what? Circumcision. That done in the what? The body by the hands of men. By the hands of what? By the hands of what? Jump it again. Go. Verse what? Verse 12. Am I right? Look at this. Remember that at that time, you were what? Separate from Christ. Excluded from citizens in Israel and foreigners to the covenant of promise without hope and without God in the world.
But now, in Christ Jesus, you who once were far away have been brought near by the blood of Christ. We were far away, and we have been brought by the what? By the what? By the what? By the blood of what? Christ.
Every promises that belong to the Israelites or that pertains for them, it belongs to us. Because I am a spiritual Jewish. Because of the blood of Jesus, I have become a partaker of their inheritance. Because we were far away. They used to call us uncircumcised people. Shout hallelujah. But now because of the blood of Jesus Christ, we have what? Oh, I like it. Verse what? Look at this. But now in Christ Jesus, you who once were far away have been brought near through. Look at this. Has been brought. I don't know. Listen to me. Has been brought near, not by the blood. What is the meaning of through? So it means that the death of Jesus, his pains, his agony, disgrace, shame in the land of Calvary was not in vain. That pain has brought us from afar. That blood has brought us from afar. And now we are partakers of the things of God. Am I speaking to somebody? Look at verse 13. Look into your Bible. And up to 14, and I'm done. But now, but what? But now, in Christ Jesus, am I right? You who once were what? Far away has been brought near by the blood of Christ. Look at 14. For he himself is our peace. Who has made the two what? Groups one. And has destroyed the barrier, am I right? And dividing walls of hostility. By setting aside in his what? Flesh. The law with his command and regulations, am I right? His purpose was to create him. His purpose was to what? Create in himself one. New what? Humanity. Shout hallelujah. Out of the what? Out of the what? Out of the what? The two. That's making peace. And in one body, reconcile both of them to God through the cross, by which he put to death by their what? Hostility. He came and preached peace. He came and preached what? Peace. To you who were far away, and peace to those who were what? Near. For through him we both have access to the Father by one Spirit. From today going, do not joke about your salvation. Amen. Ephesians 2:12 wants you to know that your salvation is a what? It's a covenant. Because you came through the blood. Salvation is not cheap. Some people who see salvation as cheap thing, that they can throw their salvation somewhere or they can play with their salvation. Do not joke with your salvation. The way you keep your things. Once upon a time, a certain young boy, as you know, the mother will always go somewhere and leave that boy, will tell the house help to take care of the boy every day in and day out. So one time, the six-year-old boy, you know, asked the mother, "Mother, I want to ask you something. Is there any way you can leave your valuable item, your jewelry or some good things for your household to take care?" "No way. No way. I will never do such a thing." He said, "Mom, but what do you have to leave me always for this household if you really value me?" Everybody shout hallelujah. If you value the salvation, you will not play with it. If you value the salvation. So the Jewish people, Judaism, those people who doesn't like Gentiles and the whole thing, that they believe that they are extraordinary and with their beard, they better repent. Because whether they like it or not, Christ has already brought us from afar. And the same covenant they have, we have the same covenant. Everybody, that is why when I go to heaven, I don't know if Brother Solo is there, King Solo. I will hug my brother. I really love that man. Because the time he built the temple, do you know what he said? Solomon prayed. The time after the sacrifice and everything, how many bulls? 1,000. Am I right? Straight to the mountains, sacrifice all of them. And when he built the temple, you know the prayer Solomon prayed? "Oh Lord, oh Lord, everyone, anyone, not only Jewish, anyone that will bring his or her request into this house, you must," what? "Answer him." And that night, the Lord told Solomon that "I hear and I will do it." Am I right? That is called the Western Wall, Wailing Wall. They destroy them, and it's kind of the peace, sometimes kind of wars. Am I right? People go there to place them, this thing, which some of you, long time ago, I carried all your hala over there. Shout amen. Shout hallelujah. When I went there, I started putting a whole plastic bag, was 3. So the security officer, they will check you. He told me that, "What is this?" I said, "Prayer, request, man of God, pastor. My members, we have problem, big problem." He said, hey, you know, that machine tie. He said, "You can enter." The guy was looking at me. I said, started shaking. He said, 3 plastic bag. When I enter the place, everybody, they have to move for me. Shout hallelujah. I put it in front of me. I started putting it. Here will be full. And I will move to, when I read this place, they have to give me away. They found out that the guy is dangerously. Shout hallelujah. So I have to use 3 days. I couldn't finish. I have to use 3 days. The next day, I went there the next day. But the third day, a Jewish guy, beer. You can see that man maybe was Moses' uncle. I was praying, tap my shoulder. "Where are you from?" I said, "From America." "Okay, pray for me, okay? Pray for me." I can't remember. He said, "Pray for me. My name is this. You know, our king, fathers, Solomon, said that anyone, and I know you pray, God will answer. Pray for me, okay? I need prayers." With the heart and who you can see that man. I said, "Yes, I will do it." Why? If not, you and I, they will never allow us to what? To enter. When they see you, they will tell you that you are not a Jewish. But because of what Solomon said, we have the privilege. We have the what? The privilege. What they will give to you is that they will put a hat. You have to wear it. And after that, that's it. You too can enter there and pray. It means that God is not for only Jewish. God is for everyone. May you be on your feet right now. Lift up your two hands. Say, in the name of Jesus. Because I have a salvation. Because I have a covenant with my Father. The salvation covenant. Close your eyes. If you don't have a covenant with God, tonight I am giving you a chance. Maybe I believe that now your eyes has really opened. Am I right? In so many areas. And from today going, you will never joke with your salvation. You know that your salvation is a what? It's a covenant. Shout hallelujah. It's a covenant. Somebody wants to be like you. Wish that he or she can serve that your God. But they don't have that strength. Church is not easy. I want you to pray to God. Maybe you are here, you don't have salvation. You have no link with God. You've been coming to church, moving up and down, doing some things. You have no covenant with God. The word called salvation, you don't understand. Now the Lord has revealed all the secret. I want you to pray to God and say that, Father, today, may you renew the covenant I have with you. May you rekindle. May you renew. May you. Dan. Where is Dan? Dan, bring them. May you renew. May you just pray to God right now. Because before we pray, I want you to know that you are on the right word, right place. Shout hallelujah. Before we entered into some dangerous place. Because if you don't have a covenant with God, they can attack you. I want you to pray to God. Speak to your Father. Talk to your God. Talk to your God. Salvation is not cheap. Some rich people believe that serving God means you are poor and you need some help. They are foolish and they need wisdom. After all, they don't have money than my God. He has money upon money, surpluses, and even he has used. I have not seen any rich man on this earth that can use gold to what? To make an what? Artifact. Nobody on this earth. But our God, because he has money, heaven, all the streets, 6 lanes, 7 lanes, is full of gold. It means that he has money. Silver and gold belong to our God. Do not let them intimidate you because you have Christ. Maybe you don't have that covenant. I want you to come forward. Or maybe you don't know Christ. You don't have that salvation covenant. Maybe somebody invited you, you've been coming back, now your eyes has really opened in a different way altogether. Do not feel shy. I want you to come forward because I want to lead you and for you to enter into the things. And after that, we will apply the blood, through the blood, and something wonderful will happen. Will you come forward? Everybody know Christ? Everyone? Then it means that I am doing a good job. We are doing a good job. Everybody shout. Oh, just two. Shout hallelujah. Do I have somebody? Somebody who is coming? May you come forward. May you come forward. Because of you and I, the death of Jesus. It's not what? It's not what? In vain. Shout hallelujah. Oh, isn't it amazing? Isn't it amazing? You know yourself that you have no salvation with Christ. You go to church all right, but you don't understand the word called salvation. Maybe you are a witch, you are a wizard. You don't need, you don't understand that salvation and the whole thing. Come forward. Don't feel shy. Very soon there will be some witches or altar call. No, it's not a joke. It's not a joke. It's not a joke. Witches or altar call and wizards or altar call. It is time. Because God wants them. God wants them. With due respect, please, I want you to lift up your hands. You guys should say this after me. I am very happy. Say in the name of Jesus. No, only these people. Say in the name of Jesus. Spirit of the living God. Father, Lord, write our name. Write my name in the book of life. I promise you today that I will serve you. Forgive my sins. I know that today I have a covenant with you. Your blood that you shed on Calvary, Father Lord, use that same blood and wash my sins away and write my name in the book of life. Daddy, I promise you that I will serve you all the days of my life. Forgive my sins in the mighty name of Jesus. I renounce every other god, and today I accept you as my Lord and Savior in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you, young lady. God bless you. Pastor, stand there. Pastor Peter, please, after the service, Hassan. Is that Hassan or Hassan? After the service, please, I would like all of you to wait, okay? Are you crying? Oh, wow. Let me tell you this. Your sins and everything has what? Has forgiven. Look at me. Your destiny is in the hands of God. It's not men that will judge you. It's God. And if God has for what? Forgiven your sins. How come? Your past is your past. God is about to start with you with a new thing altogether. So forget about your past, okay? And see what he will do in your life. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Have a seat, and when we share the grace, I will call all of you, and you will come and meet the man of God, okay? God bless you. Everybody, be on your feet. Be on your feet. Harabaka. Hazard. Be done. Why you need another salvation? Shout hallelujah.
When you take it to the kingdom, those who are watching all over the world, our children, all of them. All of them. Yeah. Parents, they have to be. Thank you.
Lift it up, and begin to sing right now. No, throw it out.
Covenant that I have with you in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, renew the salvation covenant that I have with you in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, with your blood, with this blood, with this blood, with this blood, with this blood, the relationship between me and you is going to be strong in the mighty name of Jesus. Those who have come in between, in the name of Jesus, today I renew my covenant I have with you. Father, I know that you are a God who keeps covenant. You are faithful God. Father, I have come before you. Renew the covenant once again. I promise you that today, Father, you will do greater things in my life. In Jesus' name. Why the word of the Lord said that, draw near to me and I will also draw near to you. Why the word of God says that? May the Lord use the same blood today and link us and push you and I forward. May the relationship you and I will have with Christ, aside the word of God, may this relationship become solid and strong. I command you as a servant of the Lord, may you open the first stage, cover, and eat his body. And I command you, open the second, the number two. Oh my God. Oh my God. I can hear thunder. I can hear lightning. I can hear sounds of abundance of rain. Can I tell somebody? If I'm a prophet, then listen to me. Heaven has already put his full attention on us tonight. You and I, we've already drew the attention of Christ. Heaven is looking. Oh my God. Oh my God. Drink it. Agrees? When we finish, God bless you. Thank you, Jesus. Drink it. Now you can take it and give it to the person. God bless you. Now position yourself. Be on your feet. Position yourself. Oh, take it. Position yourself. Now, may you get ready. Say, in the name of Jesus, Spirit of the living God, because today I renew my covenant with Christ, everything that I deserve, Father, must come. It must come. Say, it must come. Today, I pray for long life. I didn't hear you. We pray for what? Long life. Listen to me. Not we cancel untimely death. No. We pray for long life. Let me tell you, when long life comes, untimely death will not have a place to stand. So pray for long life. Clap your hands. Pray for long life for your wife, for your husband, for your children. May you move up and down. Let me hear the sound. If there is somebody here who has been tormented by spirit of death, you are coming out. May you pray to God. Rambando yazeke broto sata. Rambando ya broto ze broto sata. Rambando yazoka broto sata yaba. May you pray right now. Do not look at anybody. Do not look at anybody. May you just pray. Let the pastors get the mics. Howard, get the mic. May you pray to God right now. Rimando yazo kabrata sata. Ramanda yazo kabrata yazota. Rimando te prosiketa. Kapataka. 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 Rabata. Everybody pray. May you pray to God. 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 Ibro do yazo kabro do yazo kabro do yaza. Rabato do bro do bro si anaya. Ibro do yazo kabro do so teya. Ibro do yazo kabro do yaza da bro si ya. Bro si anaya. Abro do yazo kabro do yaza kabro da. Rabato do bro so kabro si anaya. Rabato so bro May you pray. Father, I pray for long life. May you come to my bank as you. And let me suffer a war. And rather patently. Those who are watching, may you pray. 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 Pray for long life. 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 Pray
pray for long life in the name of Jesus. Long life, long life, long life, long life, long life, long life. Long life, long life, long life, long life. Rebotosa, Ibrotoso, Abrotosa, Ibrotosa, Abrotosa, Ibrotosa, Abrotosa. May you pray. Rebotosa, Abrotolos, Ibrotolai, Abrotolos, Ibrotoyosa. Abundo yes, Abundo yes, Abundo yes, Abundo yes, Abundo yes. May you pray to God. May you talk to God. Long life. Irradiate. Irradiate. In the name of Jesus. May you pray. Long life. 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 Erradi me bumpire. Ewa yesu nemo. Medometo mebia. Medometo mebia. Medometo mebia. To me biana. Emflu erradi. Asoli etiame. Ewa me health. Erradi me domi santo nino. Ewa yesu nemo. I pray that power in the name of Jesus. I cross that spirit in the name of Jesus. I pray that Lord in the mighty name of Jesus. Rebotosa, 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 Rebotosa. Abolosha, may you pray. May you pray. Longevity, Long life, long life, long life, long life, long life. long life, long life, long life, long life, long life, long life. Pray for your mother, pray for your father, pray for your children, pray for your auntie, pray for them, pray for long life, pray for long life, pray for long life, pray for your mother, pray for your sister, pray for your brothers, pray for your father. In Jesus' name, I pray that you shall live long.
Amen.
Lift up your two hands, be on your feet, and close your eyes. I declare unto you that untimely that man was you.
Amen.
I declare unto you that you will see your grandchildren.
Amen.
I declare unto you that you will not die young.
Amen.
I declare unto you that according to the promises of God in the book of Psalm 91, with long life, you and I will enjoy.
Amen.
And we shall be satisfied.
Amen.
I release it in Jesus' name.
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 Amen.
Every calamity,
yes,
devil's agenda concerning this church, we crush it.
Amen.
We reject 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 it.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Forever and ever.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Forever and ever.
Amen.
We'll open it right now.
Yes,
in the mighty name of Jesus.
Yes.
Forever. No, the first, second. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Open the other one. Forever and ever.
Amen.
If this is a blood,
Come on.
If this represents the blood,
yes, Lord.
Then with this blood,
yes, Lord.
Let it be a seal.
Amen.
Every calamity,
Amen.
Demonic attacks,
Amen.
Demonic agenda,
yes,
against restoration,
Amen.
Capitol Heights,
Amen.
Delaware,
Amen.
Gettysburg,
Amen.
We return it
Amen.
In Ghana,
Amen.
Back to the sender.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus,
Amen.
We use it as a seal.
Yes.
Back to the sender.
Amen.
Let this blood.
Yes,
let this blood,
yes,
let this blood,
yes,
let this blood,
yes,
seal all of them.
Amen.
That nobody in this ministry
Amen.
Will be a victim.
Amen.
No member
Amen.
In Delaware,
Amen.
Gettysburg,
Amen.
Ghana,
Amen.
Capitol Heights, everywhere
Amen.
Shall be a victim.
Amen.
With this blood,
Amen.
Those who want to drink our blood,
Amen.
Those who want to drink our blood,
Amen.
Those who want to finish us,
Amen.
Father Lord,
Amen.
Let them die.
Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Peter, come here.
Kadaba.
Hold it. Father, by your hand.
Yes.
Amen.
Let this blood spot this, O Lord. Let this blood.
Kadaba.
Father, spot this, O Lord.
Amen.
Let it be a seal. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Yes,
Amen.
For us, O Lord.
Yeah.
And our children, children, children.
Amen.
Give me another one. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Kadabha.
Amen.
Let it be a seal.
Yes.
If the blood of Jesus is a seal.
Makata
po. Father, let it seal this.
Amen.
Forever and ever.
Amen.
By your token and by your finger.
Amen.
By your token and by your finger.
Amen.
Let it be a seal.
Yes, Lord.
Let it be a seal.
Yes, Lord.
Let it be a seal.
Yes, Lord.
According to your direction.
Yes, Lord.
Father, it is done.
Amen. Amen.
Lift up your two hands.
Jesus.
I am going to release this onto the atmosphere that represents you and your entire family.
Amen.
The age of Moses represents 120.
Amen.
And by token of 120,
yes,
you will put it in this envelope.
Amen.
Tomorrow and the next, may you take it. By the finger of God, so shall it be. If you want to take some for your children, do it. And according to the word of God, so shall it be. In the mighty name of Jesus. Peter, give it to me. May you rush.
Do not let this hour pass you. I operate by the directions. You and your entire children. Younger, come. You. The one who breathes air. Yes, come. Kipasakata. May you come and take it. Look at me. I don't know, but listen to me, okay? You pick one from here. Whilst I was teaching, God started revealing some things, but I will do it tomorrow, okay? Your roof, what did they call it? Rooftop. Any kind of movement that has been going on in the form of a movement, listen to me, I declare unto you that that thing they have put over there that has been tormenting you is dead. I said that thing is what? Is dead. You can put, AC. What did they call it? Air conditioner, am I right? AC. But you will still feel some hot. It looks as if somebody has put heater. The Lord is telling me you don't know the reason why those things is going on. And by the finger of God, Holy Spirit is telling me that I should tell you that those things, they are dead. That saith the Lord of hosts. You are going to see breakthroughs upon breakthroughs, financial miracles, and it will blow your mind in Jesus' name. Go in peace. Everybody shout hallelujah. Ramanda yasoka branda yasoka branda yasoka branda. Father, according to your direction, so shall it be. May you take it. According to your direction, Father, so shall it be. Spirit of the living God, labro sikata siyanta. Lima hanta ya branta ya. Do I have somebody? Be on your feet. I will make the announcement also tomorrow. This is the direction the Lord just gave me. Do I have somebody? Peter, give me this. By the finger of God and by the hand of God, everybody lift it up. Lift it up. Say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Church, let me tell you this. Listen to me. If you want to, if you want to take some and put it for your children, the strength and the what? The years of what? Moses. 100 and what? 120. Longevity. Aside yours, you want to link for your children. May you come and take one. Specifically, you want to link it maybe for your mother or your brother. Do not let this hour pass you. I can sense it. I don't know the reason why. But the Lord is telling me that He wants to do some things into the life of some people. Forgive me to throw a whole thing, and it has a meaning. Sir, how are you? I told you to bring me honey. Am I right? Today is the second day, eh? I'll bless it for you. And third day, you see what the Lord will do. Thank you, Jesus. You took one? You have one already? Let me tell you this. This, your seed, has already saved your life. It has already what? Saved your life. Okay? Those who have been telling you that you will die, you will die, you will die, you will die, go and tell them that you will not die. It has been moving, going on in your dream, and it has extended into physical things. You hear them. Death has been tormenting you, but the Spirit of God is telling me that He will prolong your life. And you will see so many things in the mighty name of Jesus. At times, those things even will ask you that, why are you even alive? It means that you don't deserve to what? To live. And if you don't have a strong spirit, what will happen next is what? is for you to what? Kill yourself. You will not die. Everybody shout hallelujah. Hola. One, two. The moment you take it or pick it from the ground, it has a meaning. Shout hallelujah. Lift your envelope up. I bless this in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. And I soak this into the blood of the Lamb. Amen. With a token of what? 120. May the Lord. I gave my envelope to that man. May the Lord, by his own divine wisdom, cause a mighty things in our life. Amen. May you never lack in the mighty name of Jesus. May the Lord stand on this envelope and give you an our longevity. Thus saith the Lord of hosts. May the Lord divert untimely death. May the Lord divert sickness. May the Lord divert sickness. Because of this obedient sacrifice, so shall he be. Put it in your Bible.